Alright everyone, welcome back. This is part three of the video here. Obviously it's night, and one of the things I'm considering is, you know, when I ride for a long time, I might ride into the night, although summer's coming, so night's going to be at 8, 9 o'clock. Right now it's 8, about 8 o'clock I would say. Sun started setting around 7, so as soon as I came home, about half an hour to an hour, it was starting to get dark. Anyways, I'm going to put you on the chest mount because it's night, and I think chest mount works way better than the camera mount on the extension bar. So excuse the noise here. I'm going to put you in. There we go. Sorry for the bright light. One more click. There we go. Okay. Anyways, there we go. So let me turn it on, put on the RAD power bike lights. All right. RAD power bike's light is over there. You can see that. Now I'm going to go ahead and put on my lights. Ooh. Oh yeah, a lot brighter. Anyways, I may not do it that brighter. Maybe I will, it's night. Let me see, another thing I'm going to do is put on the rear tail light. Make sure that's blinking. And I have a light on the helmet as well, so I'm going to push that 1, 2, and then 3, and I'm going to check the mirror. I have a rear view mirror for that. And yes, I am blinking. It's short. Let me see. 1, 2, 3. All right. Okay. I think that's good. So I do have a tail light on my helmet. I got reflectors on the right and the left of my arm. I had them since earlier today. No reflectors on the leg, because the pants I'm wearing has reflectors in the back, so. Alright, so let's have a look here at the power meter. I got, if it's too bright, sorry about that, but I got one bar, so it's the same battery. I got one bar missing, four bars altogether out of the five. Alright, so I'm gonna head back to where I went and come back. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Alright. Essentially so. Okay. So that's what I'm doing. These things are super bright. I'm gonna leave them that way. I wanna see how long they last. Super bright. People should be able to see me. And you should be able to see everything as well now. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to go up to pedal assist 3. Oop. Pedal assist 3. I think that's the mode that's probably the best mode to use. And I'm on gear 7, and I think that's the best gear to use. I've got my gloves. It is a little chilly, but I know I'm going to warm up, so I'm not too worried about that. I have my backpack. By the way, if you're all wondering, when I did weigh the backpack, and it was 20 pounds. It was actually like 19.6 or something like that. But it was essentially 20 pounds. When I came back, it was exactly 16. So about a little bit less than, three something. Let me see. 16. 3.9 pounds, I guess. So 3.9 pounds less. So Okay, so back to the park where I came from, where I went to. So this should be about an hour, almost an hour ride. Okay, hopefully you're seeing all that. This is the chest mount view. It's nighttime, so I think at night it's a lot better to do the chest mount because you're not going to see the horizon. The camera doesn't pick up everything, and you can only see what's right in front of you anyway. But in a scenario, if I had to ride at night, that's kind of what I'm trying to mimic, because if I do go somewhere and I ride for a long time, I might have to do night riding. So that's one of the reasons why, let me throttle here. Okay, that's why I did bring the lights. There's one thing I did change when I went back home. It's a little chilly, but anyways, there's one thing I did change when I did go back home. That one thing was the glasses. I switched from tinted glasses to clear glasses, so that's something I might have to think about when I go on these long rides, like all day trips. So I might have to bring both glasses, otherwise I'd be not wearing glasses at all. Obviously it's too dark to wear tinted glasses. So I'm going 15 miles an hour, going on an incline here, going over an overpass. So when I got home, I didn't change anything. I didn't take off my gloves, nothing. I just did some video editing. Okay, now I'm, all right, now I'm going 19, 20, 20, 20.8. I'm on a downhill going down, so. So essentially I'm going to just take the same road back. I'm actually stay on the left side of the road, mimicking like, well, I know if I stay on the left side, I'll get to the park easier that way. All right. It is a little chilly at night, but it's okay. I'm gonna warm up here. So I shed about 4 pounds off the backpack just drinking water. I don't have my headlight lamp, so I'm just using the lamp, the headlights that came with the RAD power bike, and the two lamps that you see right here, T Rich. Both of them on the handlebar extension. Headlight lamp would be useful. That might be another thing I might pack in my backpack. But right now I got some batteries for charging my phone, my camera, smartphone, my camera phone, Wi-Fi. But I can easily just add in the headlamp. Probably doesn't weigh that much. Okay, going 18.3 miles an hour, pedal assist 3, gear 7, and that gear 7 is giving me a good workout on pedal assist 3. Going 16, it's going I was going up an incline here. Now I'm going into a decline. All right. The gloves are keeping my hands pretty warm, warm enough. I like these gloves. These are gonna work out. And they're baseball gloves too. They're batting gloves. I'm gonna have to slow down here. Let this car pass. All right, I'm gonna use my throttle. Oh, there's some pedestrian and their dogs. All right. Get back to pedaling. So, I'm glad I made this mock trip. I found that pedal says 3. It's probably the best way to go. It gets me up to 20, maybe up to 20, more than 20 miles an hour going downhill if I pedal fast enough. Alright, so I'm down. I'm down one bar already. So I only have 3 bars left. Now keep in mind, I do have the other battery in the backpack, so, and of course I can always ride the bike as a bike with no electricity whatsoever. I don't know, having the backlight and the headlight makes a difference, the one that's attached to the bike. Okay, I'm glad I got these headlights. I can actually see people. Going 17.2, 17.4. Starting to feel burn on my legs. All right. A little shortcut on that. I think I did that last time. Sure did. Alright, can't go too fast down here. Alright. Cut through the parking lot of CVS because I know there's no sidewalk over there, so just might as well just go around it. I have to say, as long as you're on like some kind of paved road, man, you can go a long way. Okay, now there's no paved road here, but doesn't matter. I'll still be riding. I'm still pedaling, power assist 3. Now I'm on some paved sidewalks. Hopefully they'll make some sidewalks there. I think they're waiting to build some more commercial buildings. I'm just sitting down riding the bike. Everything's working good. It's a cool night. I feel like it's in the 50s, maybe lower 50s, upper 40s, but it feels good. I don't feel perspirating. I don't feel like I'm perspirating too much. And I think I got to be a little careful here because I know there They're doing some construction work here. Oh, okay. I remember this. Got to go through this. All right, now I know. Remember this during the day? It looks a little different at night now, doesn't it? Let me see here. There we go. Gotta go up and around on this here. It's kind of weird how they have this, but oh well. Back on track here. Yeah, having bright lights, I think, makes a big difference. The lights that RAD Power Bikes gives you, it's okay, but reality is you really need brighter lights. You really do. Although the camera, I'm sure the camera is like a little different at night when you see things. My eyes can see a lot more, but I'm telling you, you having more lights is better than not having enough lights to see. I'm going at 16.9. I know they're doing some sidewalk work, so I'm not going that fast. That guy didn't even want to stop. He just kept on going, kept looking at me. Whew. All right. So I think this is the area where they're doing some sidewalk work. Let's see if the lights can pick it up before the camera actually does. Oh, there it is. Nope, that's the chair. Okay. It's really dark out here. There's no lights other than my lights that I have here. And it's a windy road. Okay, still going. Still in pedal assist 3, gear 7. I think pedal assist 3 and gear 7 is probably the best pedal assist to gear that you can be on. It seems to offer you the power savings. So. And again, I have only 3 bars out of the 5, so 1 bar, 2 bar, 2 bars are gone. But I'm using the same battery pack from before, alright? So I'm going to do another 17 miles here, and I'm trying to mimic the trip that I'm going on, so that I can prepare for it, and maybe, you know, if I ride all day off of one battery pack, I can use my secondary battery pack that I have in the backpack to come back home with. And I'm hoping that one battery pack is enough to take me home. And again, at the end of this video, I'll show you my backpack. All right, I can see the reflectors here. This is where I couldn't decide left or right. I'm gonna choose right. And then, still on pedal assist. 3, gear 7. Sorry, I had to duck my head. Alright. I think there's another one. Is there another one up there? Have to kind of slow down a little. Oh no, this is where the truck went through the wall. Alright. Okay, so hopefully that's it. So those headlights made a big difference. You could see those reflectors really well. And it's nice and cool. Wow. And I'm pretty warm. I should have put some lip balm or chapstick on. Lips are getting a little windburn here, but it's not like it's freezing or anything. It's cool enough to feel good, actually. So, all right, so where am I? Okay, going 17, 17.4, 17.2, going up. Okay, I'm going up an incline, and feeling burn on my legs here, but I know I can do it. I can do it. I'm going 16, 16.5. I'm losing some speed here. I got some construction work here. I gotta watch out. Okay, I think I'm good. Okay. Let's see what it's all this about. Okay, yeah, they're just making some cement here. What's this? Okay, now this is where they're making the sidewalk. You know, if you're gonna ride at night, it probably would be a good idea that you put some money into some extra headlights. The ones that RAD Power Bike gives you, it's okay if you're going slow, but if you're going fast, man, it'd be a lot better if you can get some better ones. You don't have to go overboard. You don't have to buy like a $1 million bicycle headlight, but you know, buy two cheap ones, or buy two relatively cheap ones, and I think you'll be all right. So, I'm consuming about 300 watts of power here, going on an incline over the overpass. My legs are getting tired. Looks like there's some stuff here. Okay, I'm just cruising right now, not pedaling or anything. All right, now I'm gonna pedal on the decline. All right, good. So when I went home, I assessed the situation so far, and I really feel like with pedal assist 3, you can probably go 20, 25, maybe 30 miles. I'm just gonna go ahead and keep going. That's one charge. That's what I'm estimating. So if I have two battery packs, and each of them on pedal assist 3, on relatively flat, like my terrain that I'm at, I'm in the greater Houston area. There's no big hill. The biggest hill we have is the landfill that just goes up higher. Without any hills, major hills or anything, you could probably go 30 miles an hour on pedal assist 3. So two battery packs, 60 miles, 30 mile round trip. You know, I can, in theory, I can essentially ride from one side of Houston to the other side of Houston 30 miles. So you got two battery packs you could ride back. That is theoretically, I would have to say, possible. I haven't done it. I might do it here. So I'll give it a try. That might be my next test. It is spring break, so all the kids are not going to school, so that's why I'm not riding the RAD Mini. I'm riding the RAD Rover. Okay, I'm going up an incline here, going 16.8 miles an hour. Okay, I'm down to two battery bars. I'm missing three already. So let's see if this has enough juice to make it home for me. Of course, I've been pedaling straight, and this is about a 30-minute ride. So if you think about that, 30 minutes, you're average speed is 15 to 20 miles an hour. I would say that's really good. And what I'm going to attempt to do is I'm going to attempt to not stop. Okay, this is already a battery that's been used. I'm going to attempt to go back home without stopping. Now, when I get to the park, I'm gonna ride on the decomposed granite trail at a moderate pace, like pedal assist 1, gear 2 probably, and most likely the batteries will regenerate. So, all right, now I'm gonna just give the batteries a break. All right, one bar came back as I expected to come back. Pedal assist 1, gear 3. I'll just do gear 3 for now. Cut across the grass. All right. And now I'm going to just ride on the decomposed granite. Again, I'm gonna ride it like this should give me an average, because I'm not gonna be like pedaling like I did on the trail. I know there's intersections where I'm gonna have to stop, and there's some places I'm gonna have to go, so I'm just kind of averaging it out. We got like two lovebirds over there sitting in the bench. Probably wanted it. I don't know, it's romantic, I guess. I guess it's romantic. Isn't it romantic? Alright, so where am I? Pedal. I don't know what gear I'm at. It's completely dark. I think I was at 3. Let me go down to 2. Alright. So, pedal assist 1, gear 2. There we go, giving the battery a little break. Ooh, sharp turn here. So I got 3 bars now. I had only 2 bars out of the 5, but after you slow down, the bars show back up. Probably when I speed up, it'll disappear, but I'm still traveling. I'm only using about 60 to 30 watts of power at this current time. So big difference between 300 and 350 watts of power. So using 10 times less, yeah. So you should be able to travel this way 10 times longer at this rate. Yeah. Let me see what my trip is 6.7, just like last time. So I'm just gonna have to ride around till I get to about 7 miles at least. Kind of do the same thing when I get back as well. Wow, these lights are awesome. Investing in some, you know, lights that illuminate a lot better, it's worth it, especially if you're gonna ride at night. And it's cooler right now, so I'm not sweating as much. I haven't drinking anything out of the water bladder. So let me see if we're still here. Yeah, still here. So when I'm slowing down like this, and I'm just cruising, I'm gonna take the water bottle, not the water bottle, but the bladder, the hose, and grab the nipple, and you kind of have to line it the right way, or you just can't get that nipple to open up to let the water out. So, but you can still ride, and then get a drink. That's what I'm doing. Put a little bit of lemon juice. I put that artificial lemon juice, but anyways, I guess it doesn't really matter. Still has vitamin C in it, so you won't get Lyme disease. There you go. Got my left hand on the handlebar, and I'm still pedaling. That little 30 watt helps me at gear 2, helps me just go at this regular pace, sitting down on the seat. So I'm trying to average out like some speeds here, like stop and go, but I'm not stopping and going. That's why it's only taking me half an hour to do all this, maybe even a little bit less. In this situation, a helmet-mounted headlight may come in handy, but that's all right. That's why I got two lights, and one on the left is veered to the left, one on the right is veered to the right, so I can, in this situation where you're turning, you can still see the road. Now, on another day, I know there's a mountain bike trail here I could probably go through at night, but, you know, for the purpose of timing and testing, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to save that for another video, but I know most likely, you know, if I do this trip to Herman Memorial Park here, from where my house to Herman Memorial Park, or maybe to a metro parking place, I'm not sure which one I'm going to do yet, but ideally I just want to ride from my house and just go there, so I'm contemplating that. But when you get to your destination, you might, you know, ride around a little bit, so I know the battery's going to be drained just a little bit more, but let's see how much juice I have left when I finally get home. Wow, I think I'm getting a little low on my water. It's getting harder to suck through. So that's when you know you're getting low. I am going to take a brief stop and drink my protein drink I have left over. I have just a little bit left over. we'll see how that works out. Maybe that gives me enough energy to keep me going. And I'm testing out the protein drink too. The one I got, it's called Spirtine or something. It's a soy-based protein mix. It's just a supplement, your meal. It's not a protein drink or energy drink or some sorts. Has a little sweetness to it, a lot of vitamins. I think 16% protein and other carbohydrates. So, but I just use water. They say use like milk or juice or something. I use water. I used to put milk in that thing and it would start gelling up. So when I use water, it stays kind of fluid. I could probably, what I did was I took water and I took two containers, about 2 scoops worth, just a little bit over 2 scoops worth of the protein mix, protein drink. And then I mixed it when I got here. I found out when I got home that it didn't gel up or anything. It stayed pretty consistent. So I think what I'm going to do is fill it up when I leave. That way it's already pre-mixed. It saves me on time, saves me on space, because I don't have to take those extra scooped powdered containers and then mix them. I just pop it open and drink, close it, keep going. So I think that was another thing I learned. Now I got some water. I don't know how much is left, but I'm just gonna drink it right now while I have the time and opportunity to do so. So this is kind of like, this would be the other quarter of the ride. Of course, I don't know what I'm going to do when I actually get there. How am I going to fill my water? Maybe I'll go someplace and get something to eat, or go find a drinking fountain and just have to use tap water or whatever. I might have to manage my water consumption a little bit better. But anyways, I won't know until I actually do it. But I think this is a great mock run. Gives me a good idea of what I need to do. All right. Now I'm not gonna, I may not stop for the bathroom. That sign right there is the bike trail, or no, that's just a sign, but that's where the bike trail is, where that thing was, information guide, I guess. Okay, so once I go back around, I'm gonna just make a temporary stop, drink, just go ahead and drink my protein drink, and then simply head on back home after that. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time. I'm going to check on the battery on the camera. If it needs to be charged, I'll charge it a little bit before I get going again. All that good stuff. So I feel like the backpack is lighter, so that's good. Actually, you know what? Let me check if the bathroom's open. If it is, well, maybe not. It's like some, I don't know, this is a cleaning crew or fishing. People are fishing. I'll check the bathroom real quick, since I'm gonna stop take the opportunity to use the restroom. The lights are on in the bathroom, so. Okay, let me go ahead and just stop you right here. You don't have to watch me use the restroom, so. All right, everyone, I did take a break. I drank the protein drink. I squirted the water from the water bladder into it after I drink everything to get everything, get that extra, all the, I don't know, the leftover, drink that up. I still seem to have a lot of water in the water bladder, so that's kind of good. So let me go ahead and get going now. I think it's only been 5, maybe 10 minutes. So I did go use the restroom. All right, now I'm gonna try to make it home. And I left the power on as much as I could with the lights. It did go out. It does automatically go out, but let me just go ahead and ride now. And let me get this up here. Get you all settled in. There you go. Okay, I think you're all settled in. Alright, now I'm gonna get on the bike. Alright. Okay. Let's get going now. Alright, so what am I? Let's see, where am I going now? Okay, so I think the trip was about 8.3 miles since I went around the Granite Trail. Which is all right. Now when I head back, I want to get at least seven miles where I'm going, at least headed back. So we'll try to give that a try. Oh, you know, I forgot to put some lip balm on, but, or lip, chapstick, lip gloss, I don't know, lip balm, whatever, whatever it is. Okay, let's get up to speed now. Pedal assist 3, let's go all the way to gear 7. So I'm going to be using pedal assist 3. Gear 7, I'm going to try to take that all the way, essentially make it back. Hope you all enjoyed this night ride. I know I did. Ooh, it's getting really chilly, but I'll warm up. Go. Whew. I'm going 17, 17.6, 17.7. Try to watch out for all these, what are those, barrel, warning barrels or reflectors. Downhill, and this is where I can go up to 25 miles an hour. Oh yeah, come on, push it, push it. Oh, I didn't push it fast enough at the time. That's all right. Going 22, 21, 20. That's all right. On power assist 3, gear 7, going 20. That's pretty good. I was going downhill though. All I have to do is just keep following this road. Should be alright. I'm going 18 miles an hour. Watching for traffic. Well, this guy wants to turn right, but I'm going to beat him to it. Alright. Another useful accessory is a rear view mirror, especially when you're going with the traffic. As you cross through intersections, you know, people want to turn right, and they may and you don't see them coming from behind. This mirror, it really helps. Rather have it than without it, but who knows. Not that they were gonna really run over me or anything. Okay, here's the thing that we're gonna work on over here. Okay, I think there's another one. Whoa, that's the incline, going 15 miles an hour now. All on pedal assist 3. Pedal assist 3 is probably the best overall. Conserves power. I'm still getting like, I'm going downhill now, pick up some speed. I'm still getting like 300, 350 watts of power. So, ooh, doesn't burn up the battery. Okay, so I'm missing one. I'm missing a bar now, so now I only have two. I only have two bars left. I'm sure if I use a lower pedal assist. Ooh, okay. Have to go around this here. I'm just cruising. Alright, now I'm gonna stand up here. Losing some momentum. Okay. Going up an incline. Keep in mind I'm still on gear 7. So, gear 7. Pedal assist 3. Alright, going downhill again. Let's see if I can make 25 miles an hour here. Ooh, I'm pushing it. No, 23. Oh, I'm a little exhausted. No traffic behind me. Well, there is, but they're a little bit of ways. There's one car passing. Alright. Oh. Thank you. Okay, pretty soon we'll come up against that sidewalk repair they have here. It's coming up. Here, I can see the reflectors from here, which is awesome. Okay, what am I gonna do? I was going to go around this way. I'm on pedal. I was totally unprepared. There we go. Having a harder time this time. There we go. There we go. And I knew that whole thing was coming. Alright. Oh! Sprinklers. Oh my god. I just got hosed by sprinklers. Good thing I got my rain jacket on. Whew. That was fun. I was wondering what the hell that was. I thought I was getting peed on. I was like, is someone peeing on me? And then I saw the sprinklers. And then I'm like, oh, sprinklers. Whew. Oh, good thing I'm wearing clear glasses. It got me a little bit in the eye. I still got two power bars left. Man, I sound like power bars. Sounds like that that energy bar. So, now keep in mind this is the same battery I had from the earlier trip. So, what am I getting? That was 2 hours of riding for the most part. I know I took a break and everything, that's for me, but I think you can probably do at least 2 hours straight riding. Wow, I wouldn't have even seen that guy if I didn't have these headlights. These Tech T-Rich headlights. These are so bright. These are on the brightest setting. I'm glad I leave them on the brightest settings because I could see them. Else I would have just ran into them probably. There's a truck right there. This guy's turning right. Alright, oh, more water. Oh, watch out! Oh. Alright, good thing I got my rain jacket on. Phew! That was fun, as always. Never a dull day. Alright, going 17, almost 18 miles an hour. Really different night. I can only see what's like in front of me. It's hard to see the peripherals. Concentrating a lot of things, trying to see what's out there at night. I don't think I would have done well with my tinted glasses. So having clear glasses makes a difference. So if I go on long, if I plan a whole day of riding, I should probably plan on having an extra pair of clear glasses with me. But you know, summer's coming up, so it doesn't get dark until like maybe after 9 o'clock, especially with the time change they did. What's this person gonna do? Okay, this is where I gotta turn and do all this stuff, go around. Ugh. Remember this little bridge over here? A little walk bridge. Okay. I think I have to, yeah, continue on to on the left side. To do some off-roading here now. Yeah, let's stay on gear 7, pedal assist 3. Not gonna change anything, just keep it going that way. Oh. All right, we'll however take this road, take this way. Okay, I still have 2 bars of power. I still have 2 cliff bars. Now I'm just gonna ride on the street for a while, then I'm gonna ride on the sidewalk for a while, then if it looks okay, I'm going to go on to the street. Cruise a little bit, see what the traffic looks like. Okay, it's clear. Now I'm gonna stay on pedal assist 3. I'm gonna get on the street. See, I've got a lot of headwinds here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go back on the sidewalk here. I got headwinds on this side. So when I get on the street, I feel like there's pressure to pedal hard and. That may not be the case. Let's see if I could just make it. I still got 2 power bars. I'm doing 70 miles an hour. What's the power? Oh, water. Oh, water. More water. Oh, gosh. Just getting sprayed here. Wow. Good thing the clothes I have on is breathable and dries very well. Maybe I should have taken the street. Probably that would have been a good idea. Anyways. Still going about 17, 18 miles. I am pedaling, I'm just not pedaling vigorously. I have to admit, not stopping for a very long, I wouldn't say long break, but I could see how 14 miles could be tiring, exhausting, but as long as I keep pedaling, motor's going okay. I'm down to 1 bar now, so 2 bars have gone. I know I've got a lot of headwinds here. This would be, oh, water, Oh gosh. Okay, I'm gonna take the street. There's just too much water. I'm taking the street. We got the sprinklers going on. Alright, I'm a little downhill so I can pedal a little faster. Which I'm going to do. Oh yeah, they got sprinklers all over here. Good thing I took the street. They got sprinklers all over here. Well, that was fun. Okay, I'm going 19 miles an hour. I still got one battery, one bar left. Let's see if it'll take me home. Come on, man, take me to the promised land. All right. Going 18 miles. Going 18 miles, 18.4. Just trying to make it home now. I'm gonna keep an eye on that one power bar. Ooh, watch out for the nails here. Ooh, that's right, there was like a bunch of nails in the street. Almost there. Gotta go over this overpass, go up this incline. Whew. Come on, baby. I can do it. Still on gear 7. Alright. Now it's gonna go downhill from here. Now that I'm almost home, I may take it easy on the pedal assist. Going down to pedal assist 2. Still on gear 7, pedal assist 2. Let me go back up to 3 now. I don't know if I'm gonna make that light. No, I'm not gonna make that light, so let's just start coasting. Alright, now I'm back up to 2 power bars, giving the batteries a little slight break here. Okay, give the battery a little break here. I'm still on gear 7, so I'm gonna have to really push it hard. All right, I should be next. I should be going. No, I forgot to push the button, but I'm gonna just start going. All right. I was on gear 7. I'm really glad the cadence system, the metals or the magnets where the crank is, they got a lot of magnets there. They could pick up your pedaling a lot sooner. I sure needed it. Okay. Still one power bar left. Still going strong. I'm not gonna throttle it. I'm not gonna throttle it. I'm just gonna ride it home. Alright everyone, made it back. Now I'm back to one power bar. Let's see if I can keep on make it home until with the power assist 3, gear 7. Oh, a little bumpy. Alright, it looks like I am. Anyways, I'm going to conclude this episode here. Well, hold on. Let me just cut this video here, and when I get home, I'll show you the backpack. That way you guys have a really good idea of what I got going on here. Show you the second battery. All right, let me stop right here. All right, everyone, I'm back. Just had dinner. Oh goodness, wife is pissed that I'm making a video in the bathroom. Anyway, so here's the bag, here's the setup, and I'm just gonna weigh it here real quick. Okay, let's see what the weight is now. Ugh. Let's see here, if I can get it to stand here. It's, 14.8, so, there you go. Alright, so 14.8, so it was 19.9, almost 20, 14.8, so 5.2 pounds difference. Let me check the water. I'll check the bladder, and I'll show you what's in there. So hold on.